Technology is changing fast, and the buzz around artificial intelligence or AI can be exciting, but also a bit scary. In this video, we talk about the impact of AI on the future of Power BI professionals, and in general, on any business professional. Now, I have good news and bad news. The good news is that artificial intelligence is not going to replace Power BI professionals. The bad news is, Power BI professionals will get replaced. Don't worry, I'll explain exactly what I mean by that. I'm Avi Singh, Power BI Pro and a Microsoft MVP, and my goal is to make tech easy and accessible for the non-techie business user. So make sure to subscribe and click that bell. Change can be hard. Change can be scary. I myself am quite technophobic, and for good reason. There's always some new buzzword going around in the tech industry. My focus is always to build my career not on the foundation of technology, but by focusing on business needs. Technology is a way to serve the business, to serve humanity, a means to an end. But I think the tech industry sometimes forgets that. So initially, when I first started hearing about AI, I was quite skeptical. I didn't know what to think about it. But then my close business friends, people who I really look up to, started talking about AI. And this is what I've learned from them. Let me share a story with you. When Steve Jobs returned to Apple in 1997, Apple was in bad shape. In an interview soon after his return, Steve Jobs was being pressed really hard. The interviewer talked about how messed up Apple was and asked Steve what was he going to do to rescue Apple. Steve Jobs had a one-line answer. "I'm going to wait for the next big thing." And he did just that. I'm here to tell you that artificial intelligence is the next big thing of this era. So you shouldn't ignore it, run from it, hide from it, or be afraid of it. Instead, you need to embrace AI. But what are the specific things that you can do right now so you can ride this AI wave and not be crushed by it? AI is still in a lot of ways in experimental stages, but that's what I want you to do. Start experimenting with it, start exploring it. Now, my main focus is Power BI, and yes, Microsoft has touted a lot of amazing capabilities coming with Copilot and Power BI. But a lot of them haven't shown up yet. And some functionality that has shown up is quite basic. Now we have created a video that you can check out. But as that changes, we would keep you informed on this channel. However, start experimenting and exploring with AI options that are available in Microsoft tools or other software or services you use. Here are some things where we find ourselves using AI. ChatGPT is amazing, but it took some getting used to. Now I have a ChatGPT browser window open at all times. And whatever task I'm doing, I pause and ask myself, can ChatGPT help me with this task? If it's a yes or maybe, then I pop over and talk to the bot. I'll admit that sometimes working with ChatGPT can be frustrating. It can waste more time than it saves me. But that is the experimentation process that you need, because it would help you figure out how to work with AI. So start that now, even if it feels frustrating at times. Microsoft Teams has some of the most cutting-edge AI features, including the mind-blowing intelligent meeting recap. We created a short video on that. You can check it out. But you do need a Teams premium license for the intelligent recap to work. What we find ourselves using the most is the transcript, and you don't need a special license for that. If you do not see the transcribe option, your admin may need to enable this in settings. But once enabled, you can transcribe your live meetings and download the transcript at the end. And my favorite thing to do is to copy the Teams meeting transcript and paste it into ChatGPT and ask it all sorts of questions about the recap, action items, and more. We host a lot of live meetings, especially for our Power BI consultant program, so this has been really helpful for us. If you have other tips on how you are using AI right now, please leave a comment and let us know. Let's go back to my original statement. I had said AI is not going to replace Power BI professionals, but Power BI professionals will get replaced. What did I mean by that? Let's step back and understand that AI can be of three types. Narrow AI, which is application or task specific. For example, ChatGPT. As amazing as it is focused simply around language processing. There is narrow AI for facial recognition, voice recognition, driving a car, and more. But none of that is general or super AI. Narrow AI is the only one we have realized so far, and it is unclear if general or super AI is even possible. So what does that mean for Power BI professionals or business professionals? What that means is that current AI needs a human operator or human oversight. But that is the wrong way to look at things. That's putting technology first and humans last. Humans are not here to serve AI. AI is here to serve us. Narrow AI doesn't replace humans, it augments our abilities. It makes us smarter, it makes us faster. The Power BI professionals who tap into these different AI engines will be able to serve their customers a whole lot better, build more reports in less time. Reports will be more accurate, more usable, more everything. So yeah, AI is not going to replace Power BI professional. It is going to make you more powerful. But Power BI professionals who don't use AI will be replaced by the professionals who do use AI. Just like even right now, professionals who only know the old Excel are fast being replaced by professionals who know Power BI because they are a lot more productive and create a much bigger impact for their team and organization by using Power BI. So stay with us to stay ahead of the AI wave in the future. But if you want to start making an impact right now, join our Power BI training program. I'll see you next time. Until then, power on.